I think that the greatest World Series ever played, I know some of the old timers may argue, was the Red Sox-Cincinnati Series of 75. Every game had something outstanding in it. The greatest baseball game I think ever played in America, I'm sure there are dozens more that people could bring up, was the sixth game of that series.
Let me tell you something, man. I played 3,500 games, and that's the most exciting game I ever played.
It was probably the greatest game in World Series history. I mean, it was just amazing.
Lead changes, comebacks, it had everything.
A big part of what made this game so special was the teams who were involved. On one end stood the Cincinnati Reds, aka the Big Red Machine.
The 75-76 team, I can say this, how do you explain it right? They were all men.
The Big Red Machine was the most entertaining team in the history of baseball.
The Reds lineup featured baseball legends Johnny Bench, Tony Perez, Joe Morgan, and Pete Rose. Cincinnati had been a powerhouse throughout the 1970s, but they had yet to win a championship. On the other side were the underdog Boston Red Sox. They had their fair share of stars, including Carl Yastrzemski, Carlton Fisk, and Fred Lynn. However, the Red Sox had not won the World Series since 1918. This matchup lent itself well to a classic game. World Series games are played one after the other, so they fail to carry the same atmosphere as a Super Bowl does. But something special happened before Game 6 of the 75 World Series. It rained. In fact, it rained for 3 days. This gave members of the press plenty of time to hype up the matchup. As a result of this hype up, the Tuesday night game attracted a record television audience. Games don't always live up to the hype, but this game exceeded it. On the mound for Boston was Louis Tiant, who had been lights out since September. Tiant took care of business in the first, and Fred Lynn cracked a 3-run homer in the bottom of the inning.
And there's a high fly ball deep to right field, going back for deep, forget it, it's gone.
Tiant held the Reds until the fifth, when they tied the game at 3-3. In the seventh, George Foster doubled to give the Reds a 5-3 lead. A Cesar Geronimo home run in the eighth seemed to put away the Sox. But in the bottom of the eighth, with two on and two out, pinch hitter Bernie Carbo came to bat.
Deep center field, way back, we're tied up!
When I hit it, I really didn't think the ball was out of the park. And as I rounded first, I saw Geronimo turn his back, and I said, man, this ball's got a chance. And next thing you know, it's a home run.
Boston threatened to score in the bottom of the ninth, but Cincinnati escaped a bases-loaded jam.
They're tagging up at third. Here comes the throw. It is in time!
In the 11th inning, Dwight Evans saved the game for the Red Sox by turning a miraculous double play.
Well hit, right field, deep. Evans is going back near the wall, and oh, what a catch he made! What a catch by Dwight Evans, and it's a double play!
Finally, in the bottom of the 12th inning, Carlton Fisk stepped up to the plate.
Beautiful morning, yeah, the sun in my morning, babe.
It's hard to dispute the contents of this game being great, but there is one problem. The Red Sox lost Game 7. This led many to conclude that Game 6, although exciting, was meaningless. That is where I disagree. In the early 70s, baseball's popularity was declining, but this game showed the world that it was still a relevant sport, and it helped boost ratings.
I think we did some really good things, both teams. We put baseball back on the map.
In addition, the now iconic reaction shot of Fisk helped change television.
People tell me, and I've read, that even till today, it's more considered one of the most memorable and best shots in sports history.
So yes, the Red Sox may have lost the series, but the impact of this game was still enormous.
October 21st, 1975.
Biggest game in Red Sox history?
Yeah, sure.
My friends and I had slept out on the sidewalk all night to get tickets.
You got tickets?
Yep.
Someday, I wanna lay down like God did on Sunday. Sunday, I remember three songs, Sunday, that way.